Johannes Gebregiorgis, Mobile Donkey Library.
Making a difference in your world.
It is school closing time in Owosso. A donkey-drawn wagon trundles into a public square, and children come. Donkey carts are common here, but a cart filled with tales of fantasy and faraway lands is unique. It's the Donkey Mobile Library, bringing books to children who have none. Donkey Library founder Johannes Gebregiorgis holds his young audience captive with his readings. Johannes emigrated to the United States half a lifetime ago. He became an American citizen, but he came back, giving up a comfortable life as a children's librarian in San Francisco because it bothered him that while Ethiopian kids may go to school, they have no books.
Most schools don't have libraries. Basically, that makes it even very difficult for kids, you know, to get reading material.
The main reason there are no libraries is there are almost no children's books in any of Ethiopia's many languages.
Most kids we have noticed holding a book upside down, and we have taken pictures of those kids. But later on we find out that, you know, those kids learn how to use a book, you know, how to flip the pages and to look at the pictures and then gradually to read the stories in the book.
Admasu Apuye grew up in Owosso. He never had a book. Now he brings his 2.5-year-old son Meseker to listen and to learn about the world inside those pages. A world Admasu never knew as well. With financing from American civic groups, more donkey libraries are planned. Donated English language books are arriving. Meanwhile, Johannes has established a publishing house to produce books in languages local kids can read. His first effort, in three languages, was a recreation of an old folk tale about, what else, a boy and his donkey.
But I grew up hearing this story. So when I first started this organization, I wrote this story and we published it, and this became really a fundraiser for us. Still, you know, sold in the United States.
Oh, and the donkeys. Originally, they were a big part of drawing kids to the mobile library. But Johannes discovered, much to his delight, that it wasn't the donkeys that excited the kids. It was the books.
And they come really to read, and they sit with books. Even if they don't know how to read, they open the book and see the pictures and just enjoy the pictures.
Johannes dreams about taking his donkey mobile libraries to more Ethiopian towns and villages. After all, there are millions of eager children. The donkeys may be resting now, but there's plenty of work to be done. Peter Heinemann, VOA News, for Making a Difference in Owosso, Ethiopia.